Hi, I'm Pamela Anderson, and I'm dragging Damian down to the Canadian consulate. We're going to send a letter to the ambassador so we can help stop the seal hunt. We're trying to get them from every angle, so this was a little adventure I thought I'd take him on.
Thank you.
There you go.
Happy to be a part of it.
There you go. PETA.
What do you got me into?
We left rehearsal. I'm going to show you the letter that we wrote. Mr. Gary Dewar, the Canadian ambassador to the U.S. I've told you about the Canadian seal hunt. I'm obviously Canadian, so that's the biggest embarrassment to Canadians, that the seal hunt is still going on when there's no market for them. And we think that maybe the government is subsidizing this for some reason, because they killed 65,000 seal pups this year, and there's absolutely no market for them. And they've actually thrown pelts overboard, and there's hundreds of thousands of pelts stockpiled. So we're wondering why they're still continuing the hunt, because they're not getting nearly the amount of money that they used to for them.
Yeah.
So, I have two questions. Why is it that sealers in Quebec were forced to throw their pelts overboard because of the lack of markets, while in Newfoundland a certain processor is seemingly able to find people willing to pay double last year's value of a pelt? One question. Given sealing industry's insider reports of a negative market outlook for this year, and given the accounts claiming that some processors have 2 to 3 years of pelt stockpiled they cannot get rid of, who or where is the market for the 65,000 baby seals who have been killed this year? Is the federal government of Canada or the provincial government of Newfoundland providing financial incentives to seal processors? So I wrote him specifically because we've tried every other angle. I've written the Prime Minister. But these are just specific things that we found out through inside information.
Yeah.
So we're just hitting them from everywhere we can and hoping to stop it. So that's the letter.
Yeah.
So I'm dragging you into something good and meaningful. It's balance, right?
Absolutely.
It's important to do, you know, to do these
you
kind of things.
You'll be able to sleep well tonight.
You'll be able to sleep well tonight after all that dancing and protesting
good
and
work.
Activism.
Yeah.
You're such a do-gooder.
Didn't you say this was put a stop to before?
I thought it was stopped this year. You know, the seal hunt was stopped early this year, right?
Yeah.
But it's still going on right now.
Yeah, the rumors are it's going to stop very soon.
Yeah, but that was the rumor. Okay, I heard the rumor that it was going to stop pretty soon because there's no market for the pelts anymore.
Well,
but
the numbers are way lower.
And the numbers are way lower. I mean, there's so many. I mean, the polar ice caps are melting, so there's no way for even them to give birth to the seal pups. So the population is already way down. Polar bears are dying of starvation because seals are their main source of food. So it's bad all the way around. It's just greedy fishermen trying to make a cash bonus on the side, and it's brutal, and it's barbaric. It's 2010. Why are we beating baby seals to death? They have the pelts are worth less if they put a bullet hole in it, so that's why they beat them, so they don't ruin the pelts. But they suffer. And before, you know, usually before they're 3 months old, before they've had their first swim, they're beaten to death. It's because it's white, fuzzy little fur that people want.
They look like baby teddy bears.
They look like baby teddy bears. Yeah. I mean, everyone has seen, you can't watch it and not be upset about it.
Yeah.
So we just keep bringing attention to it, and hopefully it'll end. It ended for 20 years, and then it just came out again.
Yeah.
It started again because of Russia and China. They're eating the penises for aphrodisiacs and stuff like that. Yeah, it's really interesting. So, yeah, it doesn't work.
Penis from where?
The babies.
Oh.
Crushed up baby penises.
The good news is, though, is that the European Union banned.
There is a European Union ban, so there is. And America as well.
Yep.
As well. Dan and I travel all over the world, and
there's
different animal. There's different animal issues all over the world, and there's different ones in every country, and some are way behind others, but we've done a lot. We've been able to change a lot of laws all over the place for animal welfare.
As a Canadian, your voice is really heard, and
this specifically, it was even with the I was invited to the opening of the Olympics, and they changed their mind really fast when they knew that I was going to probably politicize it and talk about the seal hunt. So they disinvited me, even though my friend Brian Adams and everyone was doing it, and they had to kind of say, oh, there's been some mix-up. And everyone was really upset that I wasn't there for the Olympics, because they used every Canadian in every commercial.
Yeah.
Like people, you know, and obviously, you know, I should have been involved at some way. I'm always supporting athletes and things like that, so it was kind of odd. But then when we saw that the who's that woman that ate seal at the thing? No, she was with Prime Minister Harper. She was like chairing the whole
Yeah,
as soon as she was chosen, Department of, not the Department of Fisheries, the woman, the general,
Yeah, she's one that ate the
she ate, they're eating seal at, they're trying to, like, I think maybe they're trying to create a market for it, which is even worse.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, it's so brutal. I don't know how people are doing it, but
it's just a big F you to people who protested it.
Yeah, and it's important to, you know, be an activist and protest and be involved in the world and the world's decisions, and especially, I'm sure there's some things in Australia that maybe you get involved, you want to get involved in. I think it's really important people do that, especially when you start becoming well known and your voice can be heard.
Yeah.
So that's
It definitely makes a difference, doesn't it?
And it makes you feel good. It makes you feel like you're doing something meaningful in a meaningless business sometimes. But dancing isn't meaningless, for sure. But, you know, bopping around in a bikini. Well, that's not meaningless either. But, you know, as long as you can do good things.
I think anytime you're exercising, it's good.
Exercise and activism. So. That's another thing we talk about, is being vegetarian, and how that's almost, well, it's just as good as buying a hybrid car. You're saving the environment, because factory farming is really one of the leading causes of global warming. Yeah. You know, they can't make a pound of bacon legally, can they? I mean, like, all the pigs that are slaughtered, all the food that's wasted, all the meat that's wasted, even though there are some rules in place, so much waste, and they eat so, you know, the cows that they slaughter drink so much water and eat so much food, there'd be no hunger in the world if people just ate vegetables.
They say that every 1 pound of meat you eat, it's like driving your SUV for 40 miles.
Yeah.
Wow.
So it's all those. So you just do both.
So
solar
if we
panels.
Drive this 40 miles, we've had a burger.
Crap. Well, let's turn back. And what about the, you know what I'm really upset about right now is the oil tanker. I was talking to the director of the Cove. I saw him the other night, and he's, you know, the ocean protection. He's involved in that, and it's just the damage is done. There's really nothing we can do. There's going to be all that wildlife's going to die because of our, you know, our addiction to fossil fuel.
I just kind of makes Louisiana thing. Is already still healing from.
I know. New Orleans, and it's gonna be heavy duty. We'll have to go there and clean some birds.
Now
right after
flooded.
I go to Haiti, I'm going. You have to do things like that. You have to be involved. It's important. It's good. There's no justification for clubbing and skinning baby seals alive, period. Newfoundland, income from the seal slaughter accounts for less than 1% of the province's economy. But even if it were more, there will never be an excuse for clubbing baby animals. People have always been able to replace cruel traditions with humane ones, and this is no different. I think part of their response is that it's tradition. I mean, yeah, there's a lot of things that we're, you know, we have a lot of traditions of beating women and, you know, and burning people at stakes and all sorts of crazy stuff.
Thing.
You kind of grow out of it and you become a little more, you know,
evolved
and you make better choices.
Exactly, the world's
changing. The world's changing. There's other options to baby seal fur or penises. We say the Canadian government is using the Inuit, whose hunting is not under any threat, to push the commercial slaughter. This is hideously cruel massacre condemned by the whole world. If anything, banning seal products from the commercial hunt, which make up about 97% of all massacred seals, will help the Inuit, not harm them. Tying the two hunts together is dishonest and hypocritical.
Are you okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay,
I'm ready for him to, like, all his overload.
He's like, oh my, I know, I'm sorry.
Wait, are we on seals?
We're getting to know each other. We've been dancing for over a month, and I kind of disappear and do these things. I said, you have to come along. This is really cool. You'll like it. He's very sympathetic.
Definitely.
Yeah,
his girlfriend's
really cool
name is PETA.
That's really nice.
Yeah.
Gotta support. Yeah. Pam's doing everything possibly she can for me to dance, so I gotta help out as well.
You did get the best partner.
Totally.
Yes, you did.
I'm sorry. I know. I mean, I shouldn't be like that. But.
Totally. I know that.
She's the most likable, I think.
To us. We like me.
Well, America's voting.
That's good. Yeah. Thank God.
Yeah, we need those votes.
It's fun staying on, but holy Christmas. God, they got me doing cha-cha-cha group things, and they've got me, now we're doing a waltz.
Oh, Lord. Didn't you already, what was that thing you did that one night we were there? The fox
you
shot.
Were? Oh.
Ah, yeah, the mountain.
Remember when?
I remember.
I was in your trailer.
Yeah, it was, well, start there.
The what?
There you go. Done. Dragging Damian into this.
We good.
It's good. case we have to do it. So we're going up to the ninth.
Yeah.
Gary Doerr.
Definitely different, they're up.
Gary Doerr, ninth floor. His Excellency Gary Doerr.
You guys get on together. Let's
take
some elevator
shots. Okay, let's go. Yeah, this is good. Just a little side trip on the way from rehearsal.
Bit of time out.
Yeah, thank you for doing this, by the way. See, we're in this together.
You need your partner.
I do. Okay.
You are now a partner in crime.
Partner in crime. Officially. Great. Well, I'm excited. This is good. Okay.
You're welcome. Bye. It's the ninth floor?
Mm-hmm. See, you can't help but be sympathetic. As soon as you explain it to someone, like he said, he's never heard of any of this before.
Exactly. This is the first time you've heard of this newsletter?
Except
we gotta show you the video. You gotta go to our website and see the video.
For sure.
Yeah.
We'll reenact it by you kicking the shell in the shirt there.
Yeah, that's what it's like.
Just the ninth floor?
Yep. This
side is the left. Hi, guys.
I just wanted to send a letter, give a letter to the ambassador, the Canadian ambassador about the seal hunt. Can I give it to you or can I give it to...
Guys, I need all electrical equipment turned off right now.
I can just give it to him really fast and
make
it
right here.
This is right here. We're sending the letter.
I appreciate it. I just want to start the letter off.
All right.
Right here?
Who took the pictures, by the way?
Hi. I'd like to give, I want to send a letter to the Canadian ambassador.
I'm not taking it.
I mean, Mr. Gary Doerr.
Well, don't record anything right here.
Pardon me? The seal hunt. Just wanted to send a letter. Is this the one here? I'll give you this one, and then what, this is the one I want to give him.
They're all the same.
Okay. Thank you.
You can make sure that he gets that?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Right, thank you.
Sorry about that. I bet he doesn't like this.
Yeah, perfect.
Are you there with you guys?
We're going down.
Yeah,
we're
going
down. To the camera.
We're leaving.
Okay,
we're taking off.
Just trying to stop the seal hunt.
Oh, I understand.
Can we take pictures in the elevator?
No.
What?
Okay. Oh, Canada.
Let's bust out in song.
I know.
They were very nice.
So nice.
Your security guard was really nice.
Yeah, he was cool. Wake up, you know. People must do this all the time.
Thank you.
Bye.
Isn't it? Yeah, what's gonna happen?
Yeah. But you know what? It's worth it. So hopefully they'll do what they said.
Yeah.
Right?
Pass it on.
Yeah.
We'll hopefully get a response.
Yeah.
We'll call the office immediately.
Yep.
Make sure he gets the letter.
Yep. It's a little crazy. Sometimes they pull you aside just to, you know, make you feel. But you can do this. Everyone's right to be able to deliver a letter to like that. Okay. Well, that was good. Got a little crazy for a second. It felt
a little worried there.
I got a little adrenaline rush. You said,
"Were you afraid, Damian?
You weren't.
That was your first protest.
It was.
Okay, there you go.
It's a hard time.
Yeah, it was a quick
your first
step.
Protest.
In and out. Drop it off.
It's kind of controlled. We had to quick step our way out of there, right? Some dance moves.
No. Hop straight back in the elevator.
No, for a second. But you know. You guys have gone to jail a few times.
Oh, yeah.
Only twice for me.
Only twice?
Mm-hmm. Six times.
Dan actually has got a book out. He rates the jail's food. It's a book out. Italy has the best food in jails.
Wow.
Italy?
Yeah, well, you'd think so, right? Italian.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's not French.
Noodles
I'm
and
sure.
gravy.
Oh, lots gross. Of pasta.
I don't like gravy.
Noodles and gravy.
Ugh.
Anyway, so that was good. I'm happy. We did
Are
it.
You?
So now we'll follow up with it.
Yeah.
And then we just kind of got to go from every single angle. So there you go, your first protest. You did it.
You did it.
God, that was a big one, too. That was good. That was good. And it was controlled, so it was even better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That
way.
You
went out on a milkshake one.
No, I missed the milkshake one.
I didn't even ask him to come to the milkshake one. I wasn't quite sure
I wasn't thinking.
Yeah, I got a little
shaked down.
That shake was good.
I saw the remnants of it. It was amazing.
Yes.
Good coverage, that's for sure.
Hey, Pam, my girlfriend thinks you wear too much clothes on the show.
Oh, I've had a few comments like that, but I don't make the costumes. I like the rumba one.
Do something about that.
My favorite was the pink one, the first one.
Well, good. Well, we're doing a waltz, and then the next, but within the show, there's that cha-cha group thing, and I'm wearing basically a bathing suit, so that's good.
Yes, okay.
Yeah, back to the bathing suit. I agree. I do feel very fenced in at times. Fenced in and bedazzled. It's like, you know, first of all, once you start bedazzling everything, it even looks bigger.
You're right.
Yeah, but I like it. I mean, Randall, they do great costumes.
Got to get it out there. You got to be seen across the floor. That's half the battle, you know?
Yeah, it's actually like beautiful costumes. But they're trying to keep me in, too. Like, I think... Because a lot of the dancers wear less clothing than me. They're just worried I'm going to explode out of the clothes or something.
Oh, something's going to bust.
My something's going to bust, or I'm going to plan some kind of thing on purpose or something. I felt like that in the beginning, but no, I wouldn't do that.
An explosion of hot.
Yeah, skin everywhere.
Ratings for ABC.
They are the highest, right?
Totally. And they're still doing
well. They're getting higher and higher every week. So I did really good this week, too. Yeah, see, now I feel better. I was getting really antsy. I was thinking, God, we got to do something. We got to get out of the studio. We got to do something else important, you know, something. Yeah. I mean, it's like you can't just...
How many hours do you have to practice?
Five or six hours a day. Yeah.
Oh, Lord. Yeah.
I'm eating so many vegetables, you can't stand it. So many potatoes.
Potatoes, really?
My mom, I'm spoiled. I come home, she makes me a little foot bath now that she's come in, you know, from Canada. She makes me a little foot bath, makes me a cup of tea, starts cooking all this food, then transfers me into my room with my feet up, watching the news, putting, and then makes the bath for me and feeds me my food in bed. She's so worried about me exercising so much.
That's amazing.
She loves the show, too. She knows I'm doing it for her, so I think she feels partly responsible. Okay, guys. Thanks again.
Thank you.
See you later. Bye, Johnny.
Bye.
I'll see you. Maybe I'll see you Sunday.
Okay.
Thank you. Voting.
Thank you.
Bye. It was nice meeting you.
Thank you
so much.
Bye.
Goodbye.